solving the NTA NET paper for Geography 2020, some of the next group of questions. Now here, which of the following explains that the landforms are produced by erosion? Now we'll first pick up the depositional. So here we know levees are depositional landforms, the deposits on the side of the river. Similarly, drumlins are depositional, and then you have the drip stones, which are depositional karst valley. So the only option left here is one. Since we know the depositional, we can pick out all the erosional ones, or vice versa. Now what I recommend is just cover the 5 videos that we have covered for fluvial, glacial, then you have the aeolian, that's the wind, crust, that is the groundwater, and then the tidal landforms that we have covered, the waves landforms. So those are the 5 videos, and those cover all the kind of landforms that have been asked here. The next is a direct, a very simple question. Heartland theory given by Mackinder. You have rimland theory given by Spikeman. Classification of a state by Redzel, where he considered it as a organism that grows and dies. And finally, the law of territorial growth of a state by Valkenburg. So those are some of the important matches and a direct question that was asked. The next is, which of the following map shows average slope and relative relief simultaneously? So topographical map shows the relative relief as well as the average slope. Hypsometric map usually shows basically the elevation of terrains with the help of colors. Morphological map represents only the surface forms, and planimetric map is usually talking about the horizontal position of the features that are represented. So that is the difference here. So here you have topographical map as the right option. The next is, Hettner explained geography as a chorological science. A chorology is a study of place and regions, and it is an explanation of a geographical phenomena occurring on a particular place or a region with a good spatial distribution. Now this is a very interesting question. 38 degrees in the north and the south is considered as a latitude of no surplus and no deficit heat balance, because the region from 38 degrees, so you have 38 degrees, 0 degrees, and the pole areas. So the region from 38 degree to pole, what is that considered as? It is a region which receives less insolation and results in net deficit of heat. However, the region between the equator and the 38 is considered as a surplus of heat. So 38 degree is a region which has no surplus and no heat deficit, and it is a kind of zero balance that is being considered, or a zero net radiation. Very interesting question. The next is, OKIV is the name for the cumulative frequency distribution. The frequency distribution can be more than or less than. That is, means more than means from highest to lowest. So the cumulative frequency is taken from highest to lowest, and less than means from lowest to highest. So that is how you understand the frequency curve. But cumulative frequency, that means you are adding on the frequency. So let's say in the first case it is 8, 5, 9. So here the cumulative frequencies become 8, 13, 22, and so on. So this is explained through a OGIV curve. The next is, who talked about 4 stages of evolution in space economy? So John Friedman in his core periphery model. So his first idea was a pre-industrial society that was there, and then which had a localized economy. Then there was a core and a periphery surrounding it. Then after the core and the periphery, he explained the dispersion of economic activities that takes place. And finally, emergence of a spatially integrated system that happens. Dry point settlement occurs in a wet area, and wet point settlement occurs in a dry area. So the simplest way to remember this. So among these, which is a wet area? So deltas is a wet area. So dry point settlement would be seen in a delta area here. Now dry point basically means an area which is free from floods, or it's actually a dry region in a wet region. And wet point means it's a wet region in a dry surrounding. So oasis is an example of wet point settlement. Dry point settlement would be seen in examples of deltas. The next is, we have the deposits and the agents. So what causes what? So moraines are the depositions with glaciers. You have silt deposition that occurs with the help of river. Loess that occurs with wind. So in the desert area you have loess. And crust topography, you have drip stones with underground water. So those are the correct matches for the questions here. And finally, a last interesting question. What is meta geopolitics? We'll understand this. So, meta geopolitics is a nuanced treatment for understanding the state power in terms of seven different capacities. One of those is the social and the health issues. The next is the internal or the domestic politics, the environment, the economics, the military issues, international diplomacy, and science and human potential. So, those are the seven important aspects that we understand under meta geopolitics. So that is the right answer here. Now, these were the kind of questions that were asked in your NTA NET examination. Not very difficult, but yes, contemporary. So you have to remain updated with your preparation. A lot of updated information is part of your NTA NET syllabus. We would be covering many more interesting lectures on geography in the upcoming sessions. Stay tuned. Have a wonderful day.